Well, hello out there, internet, world wide web world. I thought I'd actually make a video with my face, although I don't do it too often. Wanted to show you who I am that makes all these videos on Microsoft Office products. Melody Cronister here from the lovely Imperial Valley. So, with that said, I wanted to give Mac a shout out. I feel that Mac doesn't necessarily get a lot of attention when it comes to Microsoft Office, because let's face it, it's Windows, so PC. But there are Mac users out there that use Microsoft Office products like myself. So I wanted to show you what that looks like on a Mac. So this is what Outlook 2016 looks like. As you can see, a lot of similar options, but the look and feel definitely has an Apple flair. Instead of the close X here on the right, you see the close, minimize, and expand on the left. That's a Mac thing. And then the menu options, again, a lot of the features are the same, but in different places. So let's just do a quick tour, if we will. So to access your Office account or preferences, that's actually going to be here along the very top. You just click Outlook and then go to Preferences. And then just like we saw on the Windows version, you see the account setting, general settings, notification and sounds. This is where you would modify all of this. So for example, fonts. This would be where we would change the font of our new mail or our replies and so on. Click Show All to go back and you will see all these other options available. So for email, you would go ahead if you wanted to change your signature. You can do that here. And rules and alerts, which we'll cover later on in this class on the Windows version, but that's where you're going to find that option here. And your calendar, contacts, and security. So all in our Outlook preferences, which you get to from the top menu here. The folders are still along the left. The emails are still here in the center, and you can still add and remove columns and sort by clicking on them. For organize, you can see similar options. This is where we can turn on and off conversations, turn on and off our reading pane, change what our emails are arranged by, and even set up folder permissions. For tools, once again, we have another way to access our accounts. Love how Outlook and Microsoft give us a million ways to do one thing. And turn on our out of office assistant. So if you're not going to be checking your emails for a few days or a week, you could turn that on and they'll automatically get a reply that you're out. And then public folders, if you have access to any, if you're on, for example, a Microsoft Exchange network. Import, export, sync status. If you're seeing that your emails aren't sending, you can check on the status here. Little trick for you, bottom right. It shows that whether or not you're connected. So it shows I'm connected to the Imperial account and that all my folders are up to date, so I'm good to go. And back to the home. So just a very quick tour of the Mac version. This class we are going to focus on the PC version, but just wanted to give you a glimpse for all those Mac users out there that Outlook is fabulous for Mac, just as it is for PCs. And take advantage of it. If you have a Mac, download the product and use it, because it's handy no matter what computer you're using. This is Melody signing off.